How are we doing? Don't worry, I've managed to get a crowd on my own without you. Better late than never. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, thank you everyone who's gathered by waiting so patiently here for something to begin. Before I do this stunt, let me explain what's about to happen, because I don't want to cause you guys any alarm or distress or anxiety. That's not what I'm here to do. Quite the opposite. As a street performer, I'm here to cheer you guys up. Some of you look like you could do with it. So, let me explain what's about to happen, and you guys can decide whether you want to watch this or not. My name is Liam. I'm going to start here, run this way. The plan? Get through these. Without a mark, without a scratch, without a burn. How I'm going to do that is a bit different. See, I'm not going to go arms first. I'm not going to do flips. I'm going to try to run through leg first in the splits. Fold my body in half, try to fly through there, in midair. Now the problem is, there's 20 metal teeth on hurdle one, and I've got to get through there safely, without touching a single one, without taking any skin off my back, without clipping my sack. Amen. Hurdle two. 26 knives. This one reminds me of my ex-wife. But like I got over her, I'll get over this. Hurdle three gets worse again. 20 hanging balls of fire. Or if I get it wrong, 22 hanging balls of fire. But we're gonna get it right, feeling good. The clothes that I'm wearing are not fireproof, so I gotta get through that one at 21 miles an hour, leg first in the splits. People, if this is something you'd like to watch, could I ask you all to be my audience and to come right up to the rope line on either side. Show's about to begin right now. Yeah, make use of both sides. You can stand or sit, wherever you like. As long as you're behind the rope, you're good. Now, to make this a great show, I've got to do my job and I've got to give you a great stunt and a great memory. But can I ask you guys to do your job? Be a great audience. When I get down there, I'm going to ask you all for a bit of support. A bit of clapping, a bit of cheering. Anything you feel like, but make it loud. In fact, I'm ready if you are. How about we start right now? You guys show me once that you're going to be a great audience. I'll give you a great stunt. Blackpool, let me hear you make some noise. Yay! Perfect. And if you do want to film this, I recommend you put your phones on slow motion because it's going to be fast. If you don't know how to do that, ask a child. They'll show you. And kids, don't ever copy anything you're about to see. This is extremely dangerous. It's so dangerous. In fact, TikTok are currently banning a lot of my videos, saying there's graphic content, I'm glorifying dangerous acts, but they can't stop you guys watching. And the reason they're trying to ban it is not because I go through the spikes or the knives leg first. It's not because I go through the fire without any protective clothing. The real reason they're trying to stop me doing this and stop putting it on the internet is because I do this stunt wearing a blindfold. Yeah. No eyes. That's why they're really worried that you guys are going to try and copy this. So as long as you don't, we're good, all right? People, let me explain how I'm going to do this so that you guys know this isn't a trick. There's two parts to getting this stunt right. One of them you can help me with and one of them you can't. The part you can't help me with is the jumping. I've got to get that perfect every time I do this stunt. If I don't get it perfect, it'll end in disaster. And the way I'm able to do this blindfolded is because for many years, before being a professional stunt performer, professional street performer, I was a professional athlete. My job was the hurdles. So I was on Team GB and I had to get over obstacles at very fast speeds all around the world. And my best achievements was I was 6 times European champion, 2 times world champion, and I got 2 world records for my country for Team GB. Thank you. So that's the reason I'm able to do this stunt without any eyes. Now, the part you can help me with, and I hope you will, is staying in a straight line. That's the part I'm actually not too good at, blindfolded on a street that slopes that way. So, what I always ask my audience to do is I ask you guys to clap and cheer loudly. Because if I can hear you guys when I run through here, I'll know roughly where you are and roughly where I am. Now, I got this wrong last year, in fact, here on the same pitch. I thought I was in the middle, and I wasn't. I'd gone, drifted off to the left a bit, and I ended up hitting the frame, hitting the spikes, getting into quite a nasty accident. So, let's have a quick practice. I'm not going to run. I'm not going to jump. I'm just going to listen. And I want to hear you guys clapping and cheering as loud as you can, 15 times. Okay, I'm going to start it. I'm going to close my eyes. And if it's loud enough down both sides, I know I can do this. Now, just before I do it, can I get everyone for this up to the rope line on both sides, just so I know where the sound is. All right? Perfect. All right, all eyes on me. Here we go. How about some cheering? Perfect. That'll do nicely. You guys do that again like that. Maybe a touch louder even, and we'll get this right. Now, just to show you that what you're watching is real, I'm going to ask someone to check these out. Who's feeling brave? Get down here. Careful. Nice and slow. Just check the tips are there. Make sure they're real metal. Some people think they're plastic or rubber. They're the real deal, kid, don't they? They don't move either. Check it out. Thank you. Okay. Who wants to check the knives? Come on. Check it out. One finger. Now, I just sharpen these before the show, so careful. Sharp enough? Yeah? Cheers. Now, I'm not going to ask anyone to check the fire before you ask. You guys can take my word for it. It is real fire. But I know some of you will be wondering whether it's a real blindfold. The answer is it is. I bought it from a shop called Ann Summers. Where else are you going to get one? Came with a set of handcuffs, but I'm not that good. Lady over here, can you do me a favor? Just check it out. Make sure it's real. It's your 50 Shades of Grey moment. Here it is. All right. All right, you don't have to. All right, easy. Fully black. Thank you, Don. I appreciate that. Thank you. All right, well, anyone else want to check it out? You guys over here? Check it out. All good? Don't ever try this, all right? Now you guys know that what you're watching is the real deal. I got one last request for an audience member. This is what I use. It comes in. It's actually a leaf blower. It comes in very handy for blowing these out at the end. Could I get this guy, tall guy here? What's it? Just all you gotta do, when I get on that box, I'll give you the thumbs up. Yeah, if I'm on fire, put me on first, all right? What's your name, Mike? Mike, appreciate it. How about a round of applause for Mike for helping me out today? Nice one, mate, appreciate that. Okay. So let me stand up on top of here for a second just to make sure you are all in the safety zone, because your safety is the most important thing here. I got one run at this, we've gotta get it right. Yep, looking good. A little bit closer over there, just to the rope, that'd be great. Sorry about the view back here, madam. You don't have to film this part. All right, last thing I'll say is just a quick thank you to you guys. You've been a great audience so far. I know some of you were walking that way and some of you are walking that way, but you all stopped here to watch this. I appreciate that. And it's an even bigger compliment that you stayed till the end and listened to me talk you through it. If I get this right, hopefully I'll be up here in a minute without a mark, a scratch, or a burn. If I've done a good job for you as a street entertainer, could I ask you all to do a good job for me in return? All I ask is if you think I've done a good job, if I've entertained you, if I've made you feel good, if I've given you a good memory, then I've done what I came here to do today. In return, I'm going to stand with my bag at the end. Just remember, this is more than just a difficult stunt. It's more than a dangerous stunt. This is something I'm proud to call my life. This is my job. It's how I earn my living. And as a street performer, my job, which is to make you guys feel good, is only as good as you guys make it for me. So when I'm standing there at the end, I'm not going to tell you how much to put in. All I ever say is whatever you think I'm worth, whatever you think this is worth, that'll be a fair reflection of the danger that's involved today. I hope that's fair, folks. Is that fair?
Yeah.
People, is that fair?
Yeah.
Thank you. If you're not sure how much to put in, I do mean this from the bottom of my heart. Folks, no matter how big or how small the gesture, just fold it up. Folks, I never tell the audience what to put in. The great thing about street theatre is it's for everyone. Some people can't afford to fold something. Sometimes people do. It's a great gesture. Some people can afford the price of a cup of tea or coffee, two or three gold coins. Some people just come up and say thank you. And that's one of the great things about this show and about street theatre, it's for everyone. But for anyone who does put in a fiver, anyone who's kind enough to put a fiver or more in, I always give one of these away. It's just a souvenir to say you've been part of one of the world's most dangerous street shows, which is cities and councils are trying to ban me left, right and centre. TikTok's trying to ban me. I don't know how much longer we're going to be doing it, but this is a lanyard, put it around your neck, and hopefully you'll remember the man who risked his neck to cheer you up in Blackpool. That's all I'll say, folks. Thanks for this. If you agree with what I've said, could I ask you all for one last round of applause? I'll do this for you. Here we go. Okay, Mike, you ready for this? We got this. I'm putting my life in your hands here, no pressure. Come on. Now, we're going to light this up. If you just arrived, my name's Liam. I'm jumping through these at about 21 miles an hour, leg first in the splits, through the metal spikes, through the metal knives, through a ball of fire, with no protective clothing, wearing a blindfold. Okay, are you ready for this? I said, are you ready for this? That's more like it. All right.
Hey, Nate. How's life? I don't know. It's alright.
Alright, here we go.
Some things like every human being and really didn't sleep much last night.
Straight I'm sorry.
That's fine. I just think I need a little me time. I just think I need a little free time. A little break from the shows and the bus rides. Yeah, last year I had a breakdown. Thoughts telling me I'm lost, getting too loud. Had to see a therapist and I found out something funny's going on up in my house. Yeah, I started thinking maybe I should move out. You know, pack my car, take a new route. Clean up my yard, get the noose out. Hang up my heart, let it air out. I've been searching. What does that mean, Nate? I've been learning. Grabbing my keepsakes, leaving my burdens. Well, I brought a few with me. I'm not perfect. Looking at the view like this concerns me. Picking up the cues, right? I'm quite nervous. Hating when I lose sight. Life gets blurry. Things might hurt me. It's probably gonna be a long journey, but it's worth it. The whole cold world out there.
Okay. Get your hands ready, people. Get your lungs ready. Put it together. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to stand on top of here. Big thank you to Mike for helping me out today. How about a round of applause for Mike? And a big round of applause for me for getting this right. Let me hear you. Thank you.